I mean, if you ask me, modern theatre has been on the decline since the late 23rd century. I mean, just look at the plays to have come out of Earth in the last 50 years and compare them to the works of Wilhelm or Barton or Chow Yun. Yes, yes. Modern playwrights have become obsessed with writing human interpretations of alien theatrical works while ignoring completely our own unique cultural heritage in the hopes of... Chief, are you listening to me?
What?
I thought so.
I heard every word you said.
And what do you think?
About what?
Any of it.
I don't know. Look, what do you want me to say?
Say you agree. Or say you disagree. Say you hate theatre. Just say something.
Look, Julian, you said you wanted to have lunch. But we're having lunch.
Yes, but I was hoping for a little more conversation with my plum-eek soup.
Ah, my mother taught me, if you try to combine talking and eating, you'll end up doing neither very well.
I suppose Garak taught me to think of lunch as a sort of arena for philosophical debate. I take it there's still no word about Garak and Odo.
The starship Portland and a Cardassian cruiser are still searching the Algira sector for the runabout. Well, that's not entirely bad news. If the runabout had been destroyed, they would have found debris by now or something to...
Kira to O'Brien.
Go ahead, Major.
Report to Ops, Chief. There's something here we'd like you to take a look at.
On my way.
About 10 minutes ago, our sensors picked up high concentrations of Tetrion particles moving toward the station.
I've never seen readings like these. What do you think?
Subspace energy fluctuations, quantum fractures in the electrodynamic field, EM spikes across the spectrum. You've got me.
Whatever it is, it's getting closer. And larger. The Tetrion concentrations have increased 10% in the last 30 seconds. There's an energy surge bearing 210 Mark 315. A ship is decloaking. It's a Romulan warbird.
Romulans? Open a channel.
Another warbird is decloaking at 010. No. It's a Cardassian ship.
A Cardassian ship with a cloaking device?
Definitely Cardassian Keldon class. Benjamin, there's an entire fleet decloaking out there.
Red alert. All hands to battle stations. Shields up. Stand by weapons. Try to hail them, Lieutenant.
The weapons are charged, but they haven't locked onto us yet.
Lead ship's headed for the wormhole, Commander.
No response to our hails.
Fleet's following the lead ship. They're headed for the Gamma Quadrant.
Lieutenant, open a priority channel to Starfleet Command now.
You should have seen the look on Legate Piranha's face when I told him I was going into retirement 3 years ago. He was literally speechless. A rare event.
I remember wanting to invent charges of treason against him just so I wouldn't have to hear his voice again.
And you would have, too, if I hadn't held you back. You had quite a vicious streak in those days.
I learned from the best.
No, you had a gift. I never met anyone else who relished a good interrogation as much as you did. Do you remember getting that confession out of Dr. Parmack?
I never even touched him.
That was the beauty of it. You just sat there for, what, 3 hours?
4.
And after 4 hours of watching you stare at him, he confessed.
I was good, wasn't I?
You were brilliant. Afterwards, he just kept saying, his eyes, his eyes. I've missed you, Elim. Things just haven't been the same since you left.
I've missed you, too.
We're both getting sentimental in our old age. Next thing you know, we'll be crying over our lost youth.
So whatever happened to Dr. Parmack?
He spent 3 years in a labor camp, then returned to Cardassia Prime. I think he's practicing medicine again. When we get back, you should look him up.
Oh, there are a number of people I intend to look up when we get back. For instance, do you remember a girl named Ducat?